You are listening to the audio version of the Time of Life magazine. Higher Life Edition 2. Page 4. The heading reads, I have the power. The beginning of the article. Dear friends, God has deposited so much in us as a result of His Son Jesus Christ, in whom we are in union with both now and forevermore. Understand this, when a man is born again and has received the baptism of the promised Holy Spirit, his mortal body gets updated instantly with power. Of course, he gets upgraded with the Holy Spirit too, but today our emphasis is on the power he receives. It is real literal power. It is called the power of the Holy Spirit as it comes with him. We see in the case of Mary, the angel said that the Holy Spirit will come on her, and the power of the highest will overshadow her. In the case of the Lord Jesus talking to his disciples, he said, But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you. Every believer who has been baptized by the Holy Spirit has this power. Also, Ephesians 3 verse 20 says, Now to him who is able to do immeasurably more than all we ask or imagine, according to his power that is at work within us. Did you hear according to his power that is at work within us? This means that we have the power and it is not just lifeless but it is working. You don't have to do anything to activate it. For the Spirit God gave us does not make us timid, but gives us power. It gives us power, not will give us power one day. This power is already sparked. All that you need to do is to use it. It is 100% there. It is more tangible than any tangible thing known to man. Everyone who has experienced it or is experiencing it says that it is like a mighty force or electricity. You remember the case between the Lord and the woman with the issue of blood. When she touched the Lord, he said that someone had touched him as he felt strength left him. Paul also told us how it feels. He said that the power is the same as the mighty strength God exerted when he raised Christ from the dead. In a nutshell, he said that it is indescribable. So, now, the good news is that this power can be felt by the carrier. It is also transferable, as is the case between the Lord and the woman with the issue of blood. When it is being transferred to a person, the carrier can feel it leaving, but it is inexhaustible in nature because its source is the Lord of hosts. Furthermore, it can also be transferred to things. In the case of things, we learned that God was doing extraordinary miracles by the hands of Paul, so that even handkerchiefs or aprons that had touched his skin were carried away to the sick, and their diseases left them and the evil spirits came out of them. This power is God's inestimable gift to everyone who believes in his Son. Yes, it is from God to his sons, who are on the other hand the exclusive distributors. There is no limit to what this power can do, and every believer who has been baptized by the sweet Holy Spirit has it. That is why Paul said, I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. You can ask, but how can one activate this power? It is already activated. The question should be, is there anything that one can do to feel it? The answer is yes. If you have already accepted the Son of God and have received the sweet precious Holy Spirit, the next thing you are to do is to believe that the power exists and that you have it and that it is active in you now and always. Then ask the Lord to make you feel it. Next is confession. Find power verses in the Bible that appeals to you, meditate and confess it always. Finally, give yourself wholly to the Word of God if you have never received the Holy Spirit, felt His power or use it. If you bought a good pair of leather shoes and unpacked them from their box after 5 decades, they would still be wearable. So give yourself wholly to the Word of God. Here is a true story for you. It is titled, Peter Heals a Lame Beggar. One day Peter and John were going up to the temple at the time of prayer at 3 in the afternoon. Now a man who was lame from birth was being carried to the temple gate called Beautiful, where he was put every day to beg from those going into the temple courts. When he saw Peter and John about to enter, he asked them for money. Peter looked straight at him, as did John. Then Peter said, Look at us. So the man gave them his attention, expecting to get something from them. Then Peter said, Silver or gold I do not have, but what I do have I give you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, walk. Taking him by the right hand, he helped him up, and instantly the man's feet and ankles became strong. He jumped to his feet and began to walk. Then he went with them into the temple courts, walking and jumping and praising God. When all the people saw him walking and praising God, they recognized him as the same man who used to sit begging at the temple gate called Beautiful, and they were filled with wonder and amazement at what had happened to him. Acts 3 verse 1 to 10. Please note here that Peter recognized that he had something and he used it. It is time to use what you have. We got this information from 2 Corinthians 4 verse 7. It says, "But we have this treasure in jars of clay, to show that the surpassing power belongs to God and not to us." If you have been blessed by this truth, share it. Let the world know that every Holy Spirit-filled believer is anointed. You don't need to pay anything to get it. It's God's free gift to everyone who believes in the Son. That anyone who accepts the Lord Jesus already has an updated body. If you want the Lord Jesus, call him and he would answer you. So mightily grew the word of God through you and it prevailed. End of article.